as the door opened. I looked at her blue eyes, whose hope was cast away long ago. Angela told me everything. Told me about her recent arrival at her new home, about her nightmares, about how suddenly she saw furniture moving by itself. And the worst part of it, her husband speaking nonsense words. David, bathed in blood, had vanished in the middle of the night, leaving her only the mangled body of her own son. The police described it as a father who had killed his son and run away. After the cops left, a strange symbol was found by her, painted on the basement's walls. Trembling with fear, she locked the door and kept herself away from it. Now that the police had done their job, it was time for me to do my own. I was sure to give this woman back her peace. I talked to the young lady, I noticed the severe danger she was put in. While I was falling, the lights turned off. Then I realized a lot still needed to be done. I felt the power of the entity and realized that even though its pawn was defeated, the one who had lost the first battle was myself. I needed to stand watch over that house to make sure nobody would get hurt. As time passed, I accepted the idea that everything I could possibly do was already done. I warned and talked to many families that moved there. And thank God, no bad thing happened at that evil place. Until last month. My God!